like, this is a destination club. It's no longer a, you know, stepping stone club. And I'm just going to reiterate that. Like, that's a huge deal. A huge deal. There's no loyalty anymore.
It's a big statement you've made, and it's spot on. We are a destination club now. We're not a stepping stone. We're not a make weight. We are finally, you don't need to go to Real Madrid. You don't need to go to Barcelona. You are at a club that is challenging. And I think what Kyle said is spot on, Paddy. But I want to stay on the manager for a second, because I don't want to say there's been some talk around his contract this week, but he was certainly asked about 2024 and not really a committal either way, Paddy. But what would your gut be? Do you think there's any chance? Oh, Stanley's just off.
It's sad stuff to read. He seems hell bent on leaving in 2024. He did say, well, if I have the energy, I will go. But I just, he strikes me as a man who is just, he has his head fixated on that idea. He wants to give his wife and family a break. You know, I think we're losing him in 2024. I think we need to just accept that. And if it does, if he somehow does a contract renewal, happy days. But I think we just need to just get ready for it. It's going to be a dark day. It's going to be a sad day. But I seen a tweet saying, I seen a tweet earlier from Ben Kelly. He was saying, this is going to sound a bit grim, but I don't think I'll be able to love football as much without Klopp. And I was like, okay, I love Klopp too, but Liverpool is always number one. And as much as I love what Klopp's done, when he leaves, we move on and we try and build again. Do you know what I mean? But I don't think we'll ever reach the heights we have under Klopp. But yeah, he's like my dad. There you go. The thought of it sickens me.
On that, people thought we couldn't replace Shankly, and we replaced him with Bob Paisley. Like, at the end of the day,
it
was a different time, though. You know, that's when the boot room, you could kind of,
it's the same principle.
I seen a poll last night on Twitter. Who do you want to be manager after Klopp leaves, Gerrard or Linders? And me, neither, because neither of them are proven at the top level. This fanciful idea of Pep Linders coming in and magically continuing on what Klopp's doing, it's idiotic, to be honest. There's no proof to show that he can do it at the top level. You know what I mean? It's just, we have to be careful with this next appointment. If Gerrard's good enough by the time it rolls around, all for it. But right now, neither of them are the option we should be looking for.
Pep Guardiola wasn't proven at the top level when he was given the Barcelona job. Like, end of the day,
it's a bold move. I don't know.
Paddy, one thing that I think often gets overlooked when we look at the next Liverpool manager is the gravitas that they're going to have, because, okay, Liverpool will be in a good position with a good squad, but in this day and age, marketability of a manager and the ability to attract players is really important. Like, we heard this week Kanate say, when Klopp rings, you answer, when he was speaking about Jurgen Klopp being interested in him. So that is my worry as well, because Gerrard would certainly have that pull, that sway.
Oh, absolutely. I mean, look at the transfers he's already done for Aston Villa. You know, there has to be a certain charisma and attractiveness of a manager. Like you said, marketability. Klopp has that. Like, who doesn't love Klopp? Everyone loves Klopp. Klopp as a person. And so you can't really go up from that. I think Klopp will go down as just one of those managers who, you know, debatably one of the most successful managers of all time, right? But more than that, one of the best people of all time. He said it in an interview the other day, you know, I'm a football manager first, but I'm a human second. And just that statement sums him up. He loves people. He loves players. He's a dad figure to all these people. You can't just go out. They don't grow on trees, managers like that. You can't just go out and get one. I think the closest to that, footballing tactics aside, would be Gerrard, given his history with the club, his passion. But again, I'm with Paddy. He's not proven. Neither is Pep Linders. But in my opinion, those are the top two options.
But on this Pep Linders thing, right? You know, I'm all for it. Whatever. It's a good idea. All of Klopp's backroom staff is going to go with them. They'll be taking a break too, and they'll be ready to go with him to his next job. They're a team. You know what I'm saying? Peter Kravitz, Pep Linders might want to stay and be his own thing, but Klopp's whole backroom staff, the people he brought, are going to take the break with him, because they want the break too, and then they'll be ready to go with Klopp to his new job. Because I would imagine he will manage again. So it's not just a simple thing of Klopp leaves, Pep, you know, you put Pep there. The whole backroom will be subject to change as well. So it's a massive, it's a, it's a, it's a massive change.
You know, Achterberg will be still there, though. You can't get rid of
Achterberg. Yeah, Achterberg will be carried.
And Carroll and Caroline. Don't forget Carroll and Caroline. They're always there.
Yeah, there's they're the ones that are, you know, are not interchangeable. But, you know, and the idea of Klopp going for 6 months or a year and then coming back, that's also not practical. Off with that won't happen either.
I'm sorry. Paddy's cut across. Connor brought up names. There's no way I'm going through Jurgen Klopp's style of football to Rafael Benitez's style of football again. I'm not. No.
Never.
I love Rafa. Love him. But I'm not sitting through that style of football again when we got
Connor, where have you pulled Benitez from? Fucking hell.
Well, no, he's doing it from the bookies.
Ah.
Yeah, he's doing it off the bookies, David. Yeah. I mean, Alonso, he shouldn't be in the conversation. Not yet. Someday, absolutely, maybe. But not now. I mean,
the thing
he's
is,
in his attic. Yeah, he's doing good at Sociedad for second team.
Simeone sixth.
How do you replace Klopp with someone of his stature? You don't.
Me. Because clearly got to be me. I'm the only candidate.
It's got to be you, Craig. To be fair, you've got great negotiating skills.
There's no other options.
you've been to Turkey. You know how to negotiate.
Exactly. But you've seen the FIFA streams. I know how to negotiate.
But at the end of the day, we will have to groom someone because at the end of the, because you have
stop
to,
saying groom, Chris. I'm sweating here for fuck's sake.
Not in that way. Not in that way. These top managers, the best managers in the world, are created. They're not ready made. They are. I don't want to say the word again. They are. What's another word?
Not
for
true.
It?
Not true. Klopp was ready made. It was us
no,
that wasn't ready made.
He got relegated with Mainz. You would not have taken
from
him
from Dortmund. He was ready made. I mean, like when we appointed him.
Yeah, but he wasn't made straight away. He had to go into a
I know, but you can't. We don't have the time to allow a manager to learn on the job with us. It has to be approved, read, like, you know, it doesn't have to be. Yeah, you can go with Pep Linders. You can, Hansi Flick, I wouldn't mind. Yeah, that's not too shabby. But no, when we appoint the club, he was ready made. You know what I mean? I thought that's what you were trying to say.
Pochettino, Gerrard, Linders. That's my three.
Pochettino?
My response to that is no. Pochettino.
Pochettino. I've said this for a long time. He's the one that would worry me taking over at United.
No way, Craig. Come on. What's he achieved? What's he achieved in his
Champions League final with Spurs?
Great achievement.
Can I clarify something?
Did he win?
No, we won, clearly.
Yeah, exactly.
You're reckoning then Klopp was shit. When he hadn't won a Champions League and he kept winning the finals.
No, but Klopp had won two Bundesligas with Dortmund.
To be fair to Pochettino, he came through Espanyol, then Southampton, who he did really well with, went to Spurs and really did make Spurs relevant for a Champions League spot consistently. I know, look, I don't know why anyone takes the PSG job. It's a hiding to nothing. You can't succeed. You can't win unless you deliver a Champions League. And you can't manage a squad with Mbappe, Neymar, and Messi in it. You're not going to get them lads working. I honestly think Pochettino is a top coach.
He's a top coach, but he's no way for Liverpool.
Not at our level, though.
But nobody outside of Klopp has really going to be at our level. Like, I see Hansi Flick in the chat. What has he achieved outside of Bayern Munich? I could win the Bundesliga with Bayern Munich.
He won the quad with them.
Yeah, he won the Champions League. But I mean, that's a very good Bayern Munich team. And he did transform them. But has he been consistent enough for that team?
Before my internet cut out. I was trying to say that, like, when we go from Klopp, we're going to be a step down. You know what I mean? You can't just expect to bring in a manager as good as Klopp. Probably doesn't exist. Ooh. You're going to need to get the right manager who's going to grow.
What?
No!
Not for our style of football. He's a top coach, but not for our style of football.
He's a deli in a shop. He's a hot deli with food. We're looking for a Michelin star restaurant. You know what I mean? Let's not take the piss here. By the way,
football play similar.
Yeah.
Pochettino could work with the players we have. So could Flick, by the way. But I don't hold him in the same esteem that others do at this moment. I'd like to see what
I genuinely think, and this is probably based on no evidence, but I genuinely think Pep Linders does better than Pochettino with this squad.
Paddy, I genuinely think, and look, this is based on no evidence, but I've got a 12-inch cock.
But, you know, this thing about Pep is bizarre to me. you know, it's not as simple as just slotting him in. Brilliant, go for it. I just don't think it is. But on that, by the way, Klopp says if 2024 is the plan, it depends on if I have the energy. So does that mean he's going to retire? Because if he won't have the energy to stay at Liverpool, how will he have the energy to go to a brand new club and a brand new project? That's what I don't understand. So maybe he'll see Liverpool as his final job and he'll just maybe sign another couple of years. So I don't know. Because if he says he doesn't have the energy, then what's he going to do? And like, where is he going to go? Like, just stay, Jurgen, will you? Please. This conversation is horrible. And also, 2024, does that mean we get two more full seasons after this one?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. That's grand. We'll do the quadruple three times.